What do you want, dwarf?
I got another lead on my old pal Anvari. Meet me at the Lawnsoother Mines. There's some fancy-dancy loot in it for you.
Another lead? But we already found him. Well, found his hand anyways.
I'll explain at the mines. These ones is just south of the river pass. Now you two want something, or you just gonna stand there all gag-scrapped and slack-jawed? Pull the ring off on Vari. Hand at the Velander Mines. Feller was always tampering with souls and dark rituals and matters of the night, see? Just the sound of his hammer flattening metal were enough to stoke my fires all blissful. Shit, you better clear out before I get all frisky.
Sounds like a dragon.
A dragon.
Is this one chained up too?
Over there!
Be ready!
Yeah.
other.
More of those. Good.
Here. Boy.
Sir. Another marker.
Watch out for the dragon breath.
I am aware of it, boy.
Apple doesn't fall far.
I guess so. But it sounds so sad.
Not sure where you get sad from all the roaring and fire breathing, lad.
Atreus, here.
Yes, Father.
Dragon Shrine. I've heard a story about three chained dragons. The shrine must be related.
There were three runes on the pedestal.
We've got to find the other two and free it.
It does not concern us.
No, but it's what Mother would have wanted. And it just seems right.
Guard your emotions, boy. Your enemies will not hesitate.
Not very many graves here. This must have been a small settlement. The other ones.
If it was your mother's wish.
Yeah.
You are too eager, boy. It may attack us, and we will be forced to kill it.
Good point. I'll be ready.
We will see.
Ah!
Find out if dragons can be grateful or not.
Boy, prepare yourself.
You're welcome. One more for the collection.
Here. Boy.
Yes, sir. This is good to know.
Say, boy.
True. It means to believe or to have faith in. So they still have faith in their king? Even after he got so many of them killed?
It is a command to have faith despite his failures.
Liked her. The great huntress.
That's right. Queen of the hunt, they called her.
That's her father, and all the animals she hunted.
He taught her well.
And the last panel. Her father again. Both of them. In the snow.
And they're still there. It's quite a story. Ugh.
one, brother.
Sorry, Alan.
Wow. Look at this place.
A ruin.
Well, yeah. Those are the dwarf built it. They must have been impressive back when he ruled.
Boy.
Yes, sir.
The Dwarf King made his subjects hunt dragons and other monsters for him? Some king, huh?
Father, you may want to see this. Looks like that lever over there will free him.
He will attack.
I know, but it feels wrong to keep something caged like this.
Your emotions again, boy.
You can't hear their thoughts. I can't.
Ignore them and ready yourself.
Okay.
Finale.
beast thinking now?
Well, nothing. But he was grateful to die in battle, instead of rotting in a cage.
Your skill is improving. You fought well, Atreus.
Thank you, Father.
Ah, fresh air feels good.
So, what happened to all the people who lived here?
Follow the clues, boy.
Right. Follow the clues. Okay, so there was an evil dwarf king, and he made all these people hunt monsters. The people put them in cages, and then... I don't know.
We are missing a clue.
Back inside the castle?
No. There is nothing more for us inside. But stay alert for chained dragons, boy. Perhaps you'll uncover more about this Dwarf King.
Mimir, what can you tell me about that giant lady with the bow?
She was called Skadi, Queen of the Hunt. Her father was Thjotsi, who could take the shape of any wild creature, and taught Skadi how to hunt them all. From the ribs of pack beasts, she fashioned second feet, allowing her to glide upon the snow so no animal could evade her. She became a huntress beyond compare, even to any god. Odin himself wanted her for his bride, believing she would bear him strong sons. that she spurned his affections, and for that insult, Odin vowed revenge. It was put forth that the Aesir were plagued by an eagle who would steal the precious golden apples of Idun. Not even the finest archer among the gods could bring it down. Odin knew that Skadi could not resist the temptation to prove herself superior, and so she joined the hunt. Skadi tracked the eagle as it flew where she alone could glide, and loosed an arrow from her unerring bow. When she collected her quarry, she found no eagle at all, but her own father, poor Thiotsi, slain by his own daughter. She was overcome with grief and shame, for there is nothing nature so reviles as a child who kills their parent. Skadi succumbed to her fate as winter's blanket fell, holding her father as the mountain held her in an embrace to last eternity.
Well, that was sad.
Aye. There aren't many happy endings for the giants, I'm afraid.